Hi everyone, my name is Will Valida. I'm a software engineer and cloud architect. And in this video, we're going to be talking about managing secrets in Azure Container Apps. Azure Container Apps allows your application to securely store sensitive configuration values, otherwise known as secrets. Once secrets are defined for your application, secured values are available to revisions in your container apps. You can also reference secrets inside scaling rules. Now, secrets are scoped to an application outside of any specific revision of that application. So adding, removing, or changing secrets won't create new revisions for you, as these are known as application scope changes. In a previous video, I talked about how we can manage revisions in Azure Container Apps, and where I talked about the difference between revision scope changes and application scope changes. So please check that out if you're not sure of the difference between the two. Now, each app revision can reference one or more secrets, and multiple revisions can reference the same secret. An updated or deleted secret doesn't automatically affect existing revisions in your application. When a secret is updated or deleted, you can respond in one of two ways. You can either deploy a new revision or restart an existing revision. So before you delete a secret, deploy a new revision that no longer references that old secret, and then deactivate all revisions that reference that secret. Now, there are a couple of ways that we can actually reference secrets in our Azure Container Apps. So let's see how we can do this in a demo. Okay, so here I am in Visual Studio Code. Now, what I've done here with my bicep template is I've split it out a little bit. So for my secrets, I've created a key vault, a fairly basic key vault where I'm going to store my secrets in. And then I've also created a Cosmos DB account. This is a basic Cosmos DB account that's using the free tier, which is an awesome offering from the Azure Cosmos DB team. And we're going to store some secrets, so the connection string, the endpoint, and also the primary master key into our key vault. And then I've created a module for my container app. Now, when we define secrets in Azure Container Apps, they're defined as a set of name value pairs. And the value of each secret is specified either directly or as a reference to a secret that's stored in Azure Key Vault. So when we store secret values in container apps directly, it's fairly straightforward. So up above in my template here, I've got a whole bunch of existing resources that I'm referring to. And one is for my Cosmos DB account. So I'm storing the connection string for that Cosmos DB account as a secret directly in my container app. And I'm also doing this for App Insights and also my connection string for my Application Insights resource. Now, when we define a secret from Key Vault, container apps will automatically retrieve the secret value from Key Vault and make that available as a secret in our container app. So the first thing that we need to do to reference a secret from Key Vault is we first have to enable managed identities in our container app and then grant the identity to access our Key Vault secrets. So for my container app here, I've got my managed identity or system assigned managed identity already enabled. And now to grant the identity access to Key Vault secrets, I've got a variable up here, which is the Key Vault secret user role ID. And this is the resource ID for this permission that I need here is a Key Vault secret user. And this is going to enable my container app or grant my container app the permissions to read secrets from my Key Vault. So in order to actually grant that permission or assign that role in my bicep template, I've created this resource here. So over the scope of my Key Vault, I'm using the principal ID of my Azure Container App to grant it the role of Key Vault secret user role. It's a very fairly basic bicep resource that I've defined here that kind of sits under this Microsoft authorization role assignment namespace. This is a fairly recent thing for Azure Key Vault. Traditionally in the past, if I go into my Key Vault template, here under access policies, I would usually grant my container app an access policy over my secrets. This is considered legacy. They're moving towards kind of this role assignment or Azure RBAC model. And in my Key Vault, I've actually enabled RBAC authorization for the Key Vault itself. And you need to do this before you can actually go ahead and assign role assignments in your bicep template, which is nice because they're now like aligning to other role assignments. Or how you grant role assignments to other resources in Azure, which I think is a really cool move. Now, with Key Vault secrets, there are a couple of ways that we can actually do this. So it has to be in one of the following formats. So here, what I've done is I've referenced the latest version of a secret. You can either do this or you can reference a specific version of a secret. However, if a version isn't specified in the URI here, the application will use the latest version that exists in the Key Vault. And when newer versions become available, the application will automatically retrieve the latest version within 30 minutes. So any active revisions that reference the secret in an environment variable will automatically restart or will be automatically restarted in order to pick up the new value. So if you want that kind of full control over which version of the secret is used, make sure you specify the version in the URI here. But we're not, that doesn't really matter for this demo. So I'm just going to refer to the latest version of the secret. Now, after we've declared secrets at the application level here, we can reference them as environment variables when you create a new revision for our container app. So when an environment variable references a secret, its value will be populated with the value that's defined in the secret. So if I scroll down a little bit here into my environment variable section of my template here, I can see that for my App Insights instrumentation key, connection string, Cosmos DB connection string, and also connection Key Vault, I'm referring to my secrets that I've defined earlier. So it's very straightforward. So all of these secrets that I've defined here, I'm now referring to them within my Bicep template. So let's have a look at what this looks like in my container app. So if I go into my secrets first, I can see that all the secrets have been added. So if I click to show the value of this particular secret here, that will just take, that will show me the URI of the secret in my Azure Key Vault. Now, if I refer to a secret directly, that will appear in plain text value. So just be mindful about who has access to this. And then when I go into my containers here and look at environment variables, I can see that all of my environment variables are now referring to a secret. So in previous videos, you might have seen that this App Insights key was in plain text. So what we've done here is we've just added that as a secret, and now our environment variables are referring to a secret that we've defined here in our container app. So another cool thing that we can actually do, I haven't done it in my Bicep template here, but after declaring secrets at the application level, we can actually refer them or reference them in volume mounts when we create a new revision of our container app. And then when you mount secrets in a volume, each secret is mounted as a file in the volume, and then the file name is the name of the secret, and while the contents of the file contents will be the value of that secret. And what's really cool about it, if you have some secrets in a volume, you can load those specific secrets. You can load all secrets in a volume mount. There's a couple of cool things that you can do. So no matter where your secrets are being stored, there are a couple of ways that you can actually refer to them in Azure Container Apps. So that wraps up this video on managing secrets in Azure Container Apps. If you want to have a look at the code, please check out my repository, Let's Build ACA. It's all on this branch, lessons / ACA secrets. So please have a look at the code if you're getting a little bit stuck or you just want an example of how to use secrets in Azure Container Apps. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, give it a like. If you have any questions, please pop them in the comment section below. And don't forget to subscribe for more videos on Azure Container Apps. No matter where you are in the world, I hope you're having a great day, and we'll see you all next time.